Two women and five men have been strangled since the beginning of April. The police have set up four incident rooms, including this one at Cannon Row. It's here information is collated, like the vague description of a young white man seen lurking in the shadows of an old people's home where two of the victims were found strangled in their beds. It's a big investigation, supervised from Scotland Yard by Detective Chief Superintendent Ken Thompson.
We have over 100 experienced detectives who are looking at this, these offences. On top of that, we have many police officers, extra police officers on the street wherever possible, and the extra patrols have been stepped up.
Forensic evidence the police are keeping to themselves, but they have identified a pattern. All seven victims, including another who fought back and survived, were throttled. All the murders took place in the early hours of the morning. There were no signs of forcible entry and no signs of a burglary. Last and most significant, five of the seven victims had been sexually interfered with. The police are warning old people to lock up, even on hot nights, and to watch for people, even relatives, acting strangely.
If you know somebody who works late at night or early hours of the morning and is in fact not acting normally, is washing his clothing, doesn't normally do that, is throwing his clothing away, please let police know. We can treat your information in confidence, and it may be just an innocent thing the man is doing, but we would dearly love to find somebody who's acting abnormally, and we can't get this information other than the person comes and sees us in confidence.
It's a mysterious wave of violence that's truly baffled the police. As one officer said, we're dealing with some kind of monster out there. This is Tina Jenkins for Thames News.